Welcome to another edition of a Brobdingnagian Minute. How long is a Brobdingnagian Minute? Well, about as long as it takes for us to do a bootleg concert. Yeah!
Woohoo! Yes, Woo-hoo! we had our show recorded at Dragon Con this year, and decided we're going to share that with you for this podcast episode. So, hope you enjoy this live concert from 2024, Dragon Con.
For the sole purpose of, in case he is completely brain dead, he doesn't have to think. So it's always a good test. The more he goes off the set list, the more you know he's really out there.
That's not true.
Yeah, it's kind of true, dude. Really, it's kind of true.
I like set lists, but...
Yeah, you love the set list, just following them.
With you, I feel like I should not follow the set list. I don't know what it is about you.
With this face?
Just you.
And if you're curious, no, that wasn't on the list.
Now, the show hasn't started yet. Officially.
This is dangerous.
What's it? Yeah, we're the Lilliputian Bards. We're here to get you ready for the Brobdingnagian Bards, who will be on in just a moment. Once he finishes drinking. It's going to be interesting after the show, because I'm sure someone else is going to bring him a rum bucket too.
Waste not, want not.
Greetings all, we are the Brobdingnagian Bards. A bard by any other name.
Is maybe a little more sober right now.
Woo! Can't be drunk yet, man.
I'm a lightweight. Come on, seriously?
This is true.
I really am.
All right. So we're grateful to have you all here. We're going to be doing some things that Andrew has no clue about.
What?
Like that song. I mean, you remember we have this on a CD.
We do? I actually didn't remember we had that on a CD.
It was alive. It was Dragons and Virgins from, like, yeah, when we did it recorded live at the...
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I know. It was on there. It was on that CD. And again, for those who don't know, when we mention CDs, you get to say that. So, yeah. It works out great.
We are insidious sometimes.
I know. And all the other performers at the con are like, God damn.
Well, so
or not just Mikey.
Well, yeah, but I mean, they're lucky. At least you didn't mention the pins.
You said, but it's a musical pin.
It is a musical pin.
Yes. So the musical pins, they are, look, she's showcasing them. These are... Each of these pins is themed to a particular CD. So you get a digital download of the pin, and then you get to wear your album on your sleeve.
Right.
Yes, I have, well, a little short right now, but... Yes.
I do.
Yeah, and just sleeves.
I got the sleeves covered.
All right, let's get this rolling. I think we're going to start with... Okay.
No pressure. Oh, you just want to come across as a smart one.
No, I caught up. A long time ago, a tugboat far away, Mickey whistled out a tune, all bouncy away. He turned color after one too many drinks, and he called up Lucas saying, "Oh, dude, your writing stinks!" When Mickey sobered up, he called the board to plan. "I've got a vision, a lightsaber in my hand! Franchise, start off licensing for rides. If you're tired and you need some cash, they'll buy from you. One part mouse
and one part duck,
one part Jedi
and formulaic luck.
Oh, yummy, right?
And a goofy omelet that first leads to company.
He's the biggest test. There's a Star Destroyer shaped like a mushroom house. The Beagle Boys stand for Sith Lord Mouse. One far away a Jedi Mickey stares into space. The three moons of Tatooine replace by Mickey's face. One part mouse
and one part duck.
One part Jedi
and formulaic luck.
A Wookiee on the right
and a Goofy on the left.
Merge of these two companies. He's the biggest test. Mickey meets Minnie. The force is strong with her. He lays a kiss on her and the fans all hurl. Our love for those mice will never be the same. One part mouse
and one part duck.
One part Jedi
and formulaic luck.
A Wookiee on your right
and a Goofy on your left.
the dark mouse disappears. Wherever there's one symbol, another will appear. The duck steps forth, the cloak is black as ink. The Jedi mice and ducks now need a stronger drink. The chorus goes like this. You're going to sing the chorus, and I'll teach them something special about your chorus, because we're doing it a little bit different today. That's what the twist on this song. It's on the list.
Uh-huh.
Right. We'll drink a drink a drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of
the human race. She invented
what?
Medicinal compound.
Oh!
Most efficacious in every case.
Let's try it again.
Drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound.
Oh,
efficacious in every case.
I don't think they got that yet, so we're gonna do this one more time for the people in the back. All right, you ready right there? If you drink more, you care less. Drink some more. We'll
drink a drink a drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case.
Don't worry, you'll pick it up after all 22 verses.
Here's a story, a little bit gory, a little bit happy, a little bit sad, of Lily the pink ad, her medicinal compound, and how it slowly drove her mad. The Ebenezer thought he was Julius Caesar, so they put him in a home, and then they gave him medicinal compound, and now he's ever around.
Too brute?
Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, efficacious in every case. And Johnny Hammer had a terrible stammer. He could barely say a word. So they gave him medicinal compound, and now he's seen. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case. And Freddy Klinger, the opera singer, who could break glasses with his voice, they said, sold his tons of syrup, medicinal compound, another break glasses over his head. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case. And Mr. Frears, who had sticky out ears, and it made him awful shy, so they gave him medicinal compound, and now he's learning how to fly.
Dumbo!
Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case. And Uncle Paul, he was very small, he was the shortest man in town, so on his body he rubbed medicinal compound, and now he's 6 foot, but it's underground. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case. Lily died and went up to heaven, though the church bells they did ring, more ringing, low ringing, low and high ringing, less bass. Okay, She took with her medicinal compound. Part the hell angels sing. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound of efficacious in every case. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of she invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case. Much faster. Well, drink a drink a drink to Lily, the pink, the pink, the pink, the savior of the human race. She invented medicinal compound, most efficacious in every case.
Good job.
Thank you. Thank you.
I like that when you do that and when you sell the shows. I really like that. It's you know, it's just a little, hey, what? It makes me happy. So I was like, we're going to do that in this one, man.
Okay, that's cool.
Because I have my sip of alcohol that matches yours. And I am feeling it right now.
Wait a minute.
Feeling it.
Did somebody spike mine or what? Or did they dilute mine?
Oh, wait.
You have the strong one and I have the weak one. Wait a minute.
You know. Oh, yeah. Yeah! I'm sure I'm going down next, but that's the same. When's your show tomorrow, Andrew?
11:30.
Okay, thanks.
That's close. Put me on the spot there for a second. I wasn't sure.
But that's not all we want to talk about.
Oh, wait, there's more!
Oh, wait, there's more!
That's right. This is for the donations that all of the different tracks are putting together for. Okay, what is it for this year?
Arthritis.
The Arthritis Foundation, yes. And last year they did a phenomenal job and made the goal. And the filth trap was a big part of that, and we want to do that again.
We've been building up a lot, actually, over the years, so the track is just absolutely amazing at bringing lots of money for Con.
Yes.
And of course, it is all matched by Dragon Con, so whatever you put in there, they're going to match. So come on out, grab, put some money in there when we pass it around. Oh, are you doing that? Felix, right?
Yeah.
Felix is going to run around. He's going to do that. And I see someone already bringing some money up
nice.
This morning. So thank you so much. Well, I just got wrong key. Well, I just down from the island sky. I'm known to make my muffle shot. I see shells I walk by. Down on where's your trousers? Window high, the wind blows through the streets. In the kilt I go. All the lasses cry, hello. I went to a fancy ball, picked the slippery and hot. I was afeard that I might fall, cause I didn't have a trousers. No high, the wind blow low through the streets in a kilt I go. All lasses cry hello, down on where's your trousers? I went down to London town, have a little fun in the underground. Ladies turn the heads around, say, where's your trousers? No high, the wind blow low through the streets in a kilt I go. She looks
Well done to the dancers.
Yeah. Big round of our dancers.
Yeah, you can say they had a fling at Dragon Con. Oh, that one was there. Come on.
So I had this funny moment. So I've been playing around. I live in Atlanta now, and I've been playing at shows around town, playing Lost Druid Brewery and other places. Something struck me yesterday because I was like, much.
I wasn't here. I wasn't me. I did not strike you.
So yesterday, my voice was like sounding like crap. It was sounding really bad. I was like, and then I got to my show and everything was beautiful. I thought my voice sounded amazing. No, not to my horn. But I was like, this sounds good. What happened? And I realized it's because I've been, you know, drinking beer at the breweries while constantly. And I'm like, while singing, I'm like, oh, I learned to sing while drunk, you know. So in fact, if you ever get a chance to, if you are in the local area, please, you know, check out my mailing list and such, so you can come join me out there too.
Is that your way of saying he just dated himself?
Shut up.
I didn't mention your zine.
I had a lot of zines. Now they're all podcasts, though.
He does have podcasts. Definitely check out his podcast.
Well, we have our own podcast, too.
We do.
We should actually do a recording. We should do a recording sometime.
We should. We'll do a recording this weekend.
Before this weekend's over, maybe. Yeah. We'll see what happens. I mean, we need to spend more of our time working on our next CD, so. You know, it's funny she had mentioned that. We're actually working on a Kickstarter that will come out in November. I love it when I'm not quite ready for that.
They surprise us sometimes, too. Okay.
This is for you to sing.
A nice, happy Irish story is I got home on Monday night. As drunk could be, I saw a horse outside my door, where my horse ought to be. So I calls me wife and I says to her, will you kindly tell to me who owns the horse outside my door where my horse ought to be? You drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That's a lovely sow that me mother sent to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 miles or more, but a saddle on a sow, sure I've never seen before. And I came here by way of Arkansas, so that's what I got home. Oh, come on, Razorbacks. As I got home on Tuesday night, as drunk as drunk could be, I saw a coat behind the door. My coat ought to be. So I calls me wife and I says to her,
hey, wife!
And kindly tell to me who owns the coat behind the door where my coat ought to be. Hi, you're drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That's a lovely blanket that me mother sent to me. Travel the world all over, 100 miles or more, but buttons on a blanket, sure I've never seen before. At con, we call those cloaks. As I got home on Wednesday night, as drunk as drunk could be,
what?
I saw a pipe beside my chair, where my pipe ought to be. So I called me wife and I said, kindly tell to me who owns the pipe beside my chair where my pipe ought to be. You're drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That's a lovely tin whistle that mother said to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 miles or more, but tobacco in a tin whistle, sure I've never seen before. But can't you just imagine Guinness doing that? The Guinness tobacco tin whistle? Yeah, They put their name on everything. As I got home on Thursday night, as drunk could be, I saw two boots beneath the bed. My boots ought to be. So I calls me wife and I says to her,
hey, wife!
You kindly tell to me who owns the boots beneath the bed where my boots ought to be. Hey, you're drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That is two geranium pots my mother said to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 as I got home. It's actually true. On Friday night, as drunk could be, I saw a hat upon the bed where my head ought to be. So I calls me wife and I says to her,
"Hey, wife,
and kindly tell to me who owns the hat upon the bed where my head ought to be." Ah, you drunk, you drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That's a lovely baby that me mother said to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 miles or more, but whiskers on a baby, sure I've never seen before. Well, since Mark shaved, it's true. He shaved, see? You can tell. As I got home on Saturday night, as drunk could be, I saw two hands upon her breast where my hands ought to be. So I calls me wife and I says to her,
"Hey, wife,
will you kindly tell to me who owns the hands upon your breast where my hands ought to be?" Ah, oh, you drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That's a lovely nightgown that me mother sent to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 miles or more, but fingers on a nightgown, sure I've never seen before. I was thinking it might be Swedish. And as I got home on Sunday night, as drunk could be, I saw a lad sneaking out the back a quarter after three. So I calls me wife and I says to her,
"Hey, wife,
will you kindly tell to me who was the lad sneaking out the back a quarter after three?" Ah, you drunk, you silly old fool, so drunk you cannot see. That was just the tax man that the king he sent to me. I've traveled the world all over, 100 miles or more, but an Englishman who can last till three, I've never seen before. Based on a true story. No, not mine.
All right, so we have a new song that I'm loving to sing. Singing. Thank you so much. You're on top of it, man. You're on top.
If you do, I don't think I want to know.
No, but we do have a Patreon. In fact, right now, if you are subscribed to our Patreon, you can download most of our albums, many of our albums up there. In fact, we're putting a lot of new stuff up there. Not all of it, but a lot of the stuff is up there. And because Patreon is like the ultimate way of supporting independent musicians these days. CDs.
Yes.
Are great. Enamel pins are fantastic and help us to do so much, but that also helps immensely. So. Thank you. Yes, sometimes we do stuff.
Sometimes even more than one thing.
So, new song, and what I love about it is that it's super catchy and it's a Hobbit drinking song. But it has a special part for you. When I say mushrooms, you shall. Mushrooms, that's right. So let's try that. Mushrooms! I went because I had itch in the food that I find there. There were carrots, potatoes, bread, cheese, and mutton, all of favorite fare. But none of it made my stomach crumble, so I threw my hands in the air. Knocked open the shutters, looked down at the window, that's how I became aware. Why, it's mushrooms!
Let's do it.
Is that mushrooms?
Really?
Who has got a pretty mushroom on it?
I only did that once per show. One show. One show.
I don't do that ever. Much. Often. Too much. Last night.
Well, I mean, there is that that one incident that happened at Dragon Con years ago with all the hobbits.
What happened with the hobbits?
Well, let me tell you. A mushroom! Well, let me tell you. He's going to tell.
Don't go drinking with hobbits. Sure, you'll have grand time on my ball. But if you go drinking with hobbits, my friend, you may not want to wake up at all.
They were thoughtful and kind when they invited me to drink. A little human one,
hobbit kind. They bought me half, did another, and one more. Told stories of days long gone by. Drinking with hobbits, my friends, may not want to wake up back.
appreciative of that song, Mark. Because that is based on a very true story, more than based. That actually happened here to Mark. He went out drinking with hobbits one night at Dragon Con here, and the next day, well, I did a lot of solo shows.
I was there physically.
Yeah, you could hold up the sign. Ish. Not anymore, he broke it after that. So yeah, yeah. So I kind of have a weird, every time we play that, I'm kind of like, that was a rough weekend. but it's such a good song.
Thank you so much. I spend the time laughing at you when I sing it, so.
I've noticed.
All right, we're going to do a love song really quick. To alcohol. We need your help for this song to make it a little bit more fun. The wrong song. That's the wrong song. We're doing a song about a love song for alcohol.
Oh, that song. Okay.
Let's start with the chorus, and we'll get into it. I'll show you how this goes. This is a love song to alcohol. Which one do you prefer? Is it bitter or sweet? Smoky or neat? The best that you tasted or taste just like pee? Is it made from potatoes or flavored from peat? It's our love song to alcohol. So that is your chorus.
Yes.
You remember the song, right?
Maybe.
It's in the key of C. That helps.
Oh, good. That explains a lot.
So, your part, of course, is bemol. But then we have to start introducing, you know, a little bit of alcohol that we enjoy. So, for instance, my favorite drink is Guinness. So fill my glass, serve him. Drink it from cork to Innis. My cheeks will start glowing, my cum is growing. I'll pass out with all of my friends, and we'll drink till the new day begins. Then Andrew provides a verse.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Okay, no, I got one, okay. My favorite drink is whiskey. Woo! So fill your glass to the rim. When I drink it, I get really frisky.
My cheeks start glowing, my cum is growing. I'll pass out with all.
Oh, my lord, Scotch?
This is where we get to come up with a rhyme for it, so be patient. Andrew's got this.
Okay, okay. My favorite drink is Scotch. So fill your glass to the rim. After drinking it, I add one more notch.
My cheeks start glowing, my confidence growing. I'll pass out with all of my friends. Till the new day begins.
Your turn, Mark.
My favorite drink is Malort. So fill my glass to the rim. So when I drink it, I really can't tell if it's not just port. My cheeks start glowing, my confidence growing. I'll pass out with all of my friends, and we'll drink till the new day begins. This is our love song to alcohol. Which one do you prefer? Bitter or sweet, smoky or neat, the best that you've tasted or taste just like peat. Is it made from potatoes or flavored from peat? It's our love song to alcohol.
Meat.
Ale.
Meat and ale.
Meat and ale?
Bourbon.
Meat.
Okay. My favorite drink is mead. So fill your glass to the rim. After drinking it, I'll let you take lead. My cheeks will start glowing, my cup is growing. I'll pass out with all of my friends, and I'll drink till the new day begins.
I got ale, right?
Yes.
My favorite drink is ale. So fill my glass, they're in. When I drink it, I go for a sail. My cheeks start, I don't
didn't fail.
Which one do you prefer? Is it bitter or sweet? Smoky or neat? The best that you've tasted or taste just like meat? Is it made from potatoes or flavored from peat? It's our love song to alcohol.
Alright, we need some more.
I'm a drunk one, so you gotta take this.
My favorite drink is sake.
Oh, good.
To fill my glass.
Sorry.
I got this. I totally got this.
Okay, sure. We got it. Yeah, no problem. I'm sorry. I wasn't playing along.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. My favorite drink is sake.
Drink is bourbon. So fill your glass to the rim. I get so drunk I wake up in a turban.
My cheeks are glowing, my mouth is growing. I'll pass out in all of my friends. And we'll drink till the new day begins. And sing. This is our love song to alcohol. Which one do you prefer? Is it bitter or sweet? Smoky or neat? The best that you've tasted or taste just like meat? Is it made from potatoes?
Let's do a couple more. Okay. Hey, Andrew, run out there and find another one. Run out there and find something in the back. Andrew's coming. No, it's not hedgehog. Stop it. What do you got?
I'm waiting. Don't worry.
No, I want to know.
Moonshine pie and tequila.
Moonshine pie and tequila. I got tequila. My favorite drink is tequila. So fill my glass to the rim. When I drink it, I just want to feel it.
My favorite drink's moonshine pie. So fill your glass to the rim. When I drink it, I can tell no lie. My cheeks are glowing, my column is growing. I'll pass out with all of my friends. And we'll drink till the new day begins. This is our love song to alcohol. Which one do you prefer? Is it bitter or sweet? Smoky or neat? The best that you tasted or taste just like beet? Is it made from potatoes or flavored from peat? It's our love song to alcohol.
Okay, last two. I heard rum and I heard absinthe. Absinthe and rum.
My favorite drink is rum. So fill your glass to the rim. When I drink it, I have so much fun. My cheeks are growing, my confidence is growing. Pass out with all of my friends. And we'll drink till the new day begins.
My favorite drink is absinthe. So fill my glass to the rim. I drink it, my mind goes.
I'm just glad this time nobody said Pangalactic Gargle Blaster. It's happened. Yeah, right?
Alright, sing it, Andrew. Your favorite Pangalactic Gargle Blaster.
Oh, come on, really?
Yeah.
Okay, my favorite drink's Pangalactic Gargle Blaster. So fill your glass to the rim. When I drink it, my death comes much faster. My heart is going. I'll back down with all of my friends. And we'll drink till the new day begins. This is our love song to alcohol. Which one do you prefer? Is it bitter or sweet? Smoky or neat? The best that you taste it or taste just like beet? Is it made from potatoes or flavor from penis? Our love song to alcohol.
That was fun. That also is going to be on our next CD.
Yes, it is. We even have a next CD. Too long.
Shut up. We have one. I will not sing along. That was the latest one we did. That wasn't too far.
Yeah, it's kind of like Next Cloud. It's great and useful, but nobody knows how to set it up. Sorry, that was a Linux joke. I'm sorry. They don't always work.
We're doing this song. I love it. Oh, wow. I'm a four-man treadmiller.
Couldn't help but notice that one wasn't on the list.
No, nor is this one.
So, this...
I walked into that one. That was my fault.
This, I guess you got a song. First of all, I want to just thank you all so much for coming out.
Yeah, thank you.
That might sound like it's a closure, but it's not. I'm not just... I just want to thank you. It's, this is one of them. Thank you so much. But we're going to do a song that is a song that was that I wrote a number of years back. Years ago, I played for an organization called Swan Songs, and it what happened is I was hired to sing a song, sing some music for a woman who was on her deathbed. It was a really intense moment. So I went in there and I, you know, playing what song, you know, Irish American. I played when Irish eyes are smiling, and I'm singing the song, and I watch all of a sudden as she expels the last of her breath and passes away, very hopefully comfortably and happy. I spent the next hour in tears in my car, and it was a powerful moment. I always remembered Swan Songs. It was many years later that I sort of like put that down because I was like, oh my God, this is rough. But a moment happened when I was watching the third Hobbit movie, and Thorin was on his deathbed, and I saw him die, and I just broke into tears in the middle of this, the song, because all of a sudden I was like, oh my God, he nailed it, because that's what it was like to watch this woman pass away. So I ended up writing a song called Thorn's Eulogy. really appreciate, again, I really appreciate everyone here, because it makes this so much more fun, even when we're crying together here. And but we'll bring it back up. I do want to point out that right over there are our CDs.
Yes. And Subtlety, The Lost Art.
And Albert Pence. And Subtlety.
Subtlety. No, we really don't.
And some USBs.
Song that's not on the room.
That's because that was the last song, man.
No!
That's the last song?
That was the last song.
Well, it's been fun. Good night, everybody.
What's that? What is that?
Oh, come on. Musicians never do encores. That never happens, right?
I'm sorry, but you know, we just don't do that sort of thing, because you know, some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad.
and other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle, and this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life. If life seems jolly rotten,
Nagians Bards podcast was produced by Marc Gunn and Andrew McKee. Sign up to our mailing list to download free MP3s and get monthly updates of what's new. Find it all at thebards.net.
At thebards.net.